Hello, my little hummingbirds. How are you tonight? I hope you're well, and I miss you guys. I have been so busy taking care of my new resident, and he's doing amazing, guys. Where they were thinking that he had, Alzheimer's and dementia and stuff. God said when he came here, he was going to heal him. And that's what he's doing, you guys. He is really, literally healing this man. And I just thank God that he told me to walk it out. And that's what I've been doing. I've been so busy trying to take care of him, and I'm working as well, but I'm not going to fail you guys, okay? I'm going to still keep coming on here. I want to thank you guys for coming into my garden, because when you come into my garden, you may get healed. And tonight, the painting that I'm going to do is for a healing, because I need a healing right now. So let's get it, guys. Let's get it. I want you guys to know that God is really real here in my home. And he said that he was going to heal people, and he was going to bring people near and far to come here and be healed at my home. And I just, all I can do is say thank you for your grace and thank you for your glory. So today the painting that I'm going to do is called a healing. Healing ointment. Are y'all ready? Let's get it. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. We bless your holy name. We bless your holy name. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. There's times that God will say he's going to do something, and you may not see it happen right away, but eventually God will show you the way, and he will make your crooked places straight. He will heal the pains, the hurts, the sadness, the abandonment. He will heal all those things if you let him in. If you let him in, let him in. He loves you. He loves you so much. No matter what you go through, no matter what people say about you, you just keep going. You keep loving on the Lord. Love on him, and he will love on you. Love on him, and he will take care of you. Trust in him. Just trust in him, and he will see you through. He told me, he said, I want you to come on here tonight, because you haven't been on in a while. 8 or 9 days. He said, but this is a night of completion. This is a night of completion. Do you hear what I'm saying? I just welcome you in, Lord. I welcome you in, Lord Jesus. And I thank you for your healing ointment. I thank you for your healing virtue coming upon my audience. I thank you. And we bless your holy, holy, holy name. I just want you guys to know, whatever God is asking you to do, do it. Do not be afraid of somebody else not liking what you do. Do it for God. Work for him. Do not worry about money. Do not worry about if you're going to offend somebody. Because sometimes the hurt that you have can heal another wounded soul. We just trust him, and we thank him for everything. Right now, if there's someone right now that's having some pain, this picture I told you, this painting is for a healing. So right now, we ask for the Holy Ghost fire to come down on that pain. We ask for the Holy Ghost fire to come down upon your sickness. We ask for the Holy Ghost fire to come down upon that mental illness. We ask for the Holy Ghost fire to come down on that mental stress that's been plaguing your life, that's been holding you in your chains. Okay? Just trust that God has you in the palm of his hand. Trust that he loves you so much. We want to thank you, God, for giving us a new president. A president that's going to stand for unity for all races. We just thank you, Lord, that this president is bringing God in the United States again. Oh, we thank you, Lord. We thank you and we ask that you bless his family and keep him safe. Keep his your seraphim angels around him. Thank you, Lord. Your holy, holy angels, keep him around him and his family and Kamala Harris's family. Father, we just thank you and we bless your holy name that you have them because they are righteous. They are righteous and they're here to win back souls. Father, we thank you. We thank you, Lord, for Joe Biden and his wife and Kamala Harris and her husband. Father, you said that we all have voices to speak out. Maybe other people may not think that you have a voice, but when you, Father, give us a voice to speak out, we will be heard. We will be heard. And we thank you, Lord. Other people may not like what we're talking about, but you will send the right people to hear a word, a rhema word from you. And I just thank you, Lord. I thank you that you have Sonny at my home and he's getting better and better every day, Father. We thank you, Lord, that he feels loved here in this house. And I feel loved. He makes me laugh, and I'm so grateful and thankful for that. We just thank you, Father, that you are doing a quick work. You're doing a quick work in your people's lives tonight, Father. You are healing the blind. You are healing the sick, Father. You are making the blind eyes be opened up. You are making organs come, Father. We thank you that you're doing that right now. You're healing your people right now as we speak, Father, and we trust you and we love you. We love you, Lord. We love you. Let your healing come. Let your healing come, Father. Oh, we love you. We love you. We love you. We love you. Can you guys love on him? Trust him that no matter what you go through, no matter what pain you are in, you just say, Father, take it. Take it, Father. This pain I cannot bear anymore. Let your kingdom come. Your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. The kingdom of heaven is at hand, Father, and we thank you. We thank you, Lord. We thank you. And we bless your holy name. We bless your holy name. Thank you, Father, for allowing me to come back on here another day to speak to your people, to show them your healing painting, Father. We thank you. We thank you. We thank you. We thank you. We thank you for your rainbow colors. We thank you that you are healing us right now everywhere we hurt. Thank you, Father. Thank you for your healing virtue. Thank you for your Holy Ghost fire. Thank you, Father. We bless your holy name. How many people can have someone come in their home and they just love on them and not worry about expenses or anything? Just say, God, this person belongs to you. So if this person belongs to you, Father, they belong to me. Father, I thank you. I thank you so much for entrusting me with another soul. Thank you, Father. I thank you that you gave, that you chose me to do this work. To make somebody, let somebody know that they are loved. Oh, Father, we thank you. We thank you, Lord. We thank you. Father, I thank you for choosing me to do the work that I'm doing right now on my YouTube channel. No matter who does not like it, Father, you told me to come and do your will. And Father, I say yes to your will. No matter what I'm going through, no matter what pain I'm in, Father, I thank you that you are healing me right now everywhere I hurt. I thank you right now that you're healing your little hummingbirds right now everywhere they hurt, Father. We bless your holy name. We bless your holy name. You are worthy. You are worthy to be blessed. You are worthy to be praised. Father, we thank you. We thank you. We thank you. We thank you that you chose us to do this work. Father, we thank you and we love your holy, 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 holy name, Father. Bless us, Father. Bless us. Heal us everywhere we hurt. Heal us everywhere we hurt, Father. We thank you for your healing virtue. That's what this painting is called, the healing anointed ointment. Yes, Lord, we thank you. We thank you, Lord. I'm going to let the Lord come in right now, guys. I'm asking him right now to use me as that vessel to be able to speak to his people. I'm getting out of the way of it, and I say, Lord, move on me. Move in me and through me. He said, as I knock on the door, will you allow me to come in? Will you allow me to come in and sit with you? Will you allow me to come in and live in you and through you? That's what I'm allowing him to do right now. When you guys hear me, allow him to move. You will be able to understand when he comes in, because it changes the atmosphere. So I'm welcoming him in right now. I'm invoking him right now. The Father, the creator of the heavens and the earth. The Father of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. Father, I thank you and I praise your holy, 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 holy name. I bless your name. I bless your name, Father. I bless your name. Can you bless his name? Bless his name. Thank him for things that he has not even done yet for you. Thank him like it's already done. If there's a problem in your body, if there's a problem in your tooth, if there's a problem, just thank him like he knows, like you know that 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 God's got it. Do you understand? He don't want you to doubt anything. He wants you to trust him. He told me, he said, I want you to allow, will you, he said, listen to this, guys. He said, will you give up your freedom for a wounded soldier? I said, yes, Lord, I will, Lord. Let your will be done. But guys, I didn't know that he was going to heal this man. I didn't know that he was going to heal him from dementia and Alzheimer's, so they say. It's done. God said it's finished. God told me to pour oil, my anointed oil, on his head, guys. I kid you not. My mother is a living witness. And when I poured the oil on Mr. Sonny's head, he said it got hot. He said, that oil got hot. I said, Sonny, what do you feel? He said, Jesus is here. That's what he said. And this man was supposed to have had dementia and Alzheimer's. And God said, I will heal. If you go back on my videos, he said, I will heal dementia. I will heal Alzheimer's. And see, God is not a man that he shall lie. Okay? So I'm trusting what he's doing. even before he has it done. He said, I need you to walk it out. And now Mr. Sonny is getting clearer and clearer every day. And he's here in my home. And he feels loved. And he said he even see angels. So guys, whatever God is trying to do in you, allow him to do it. Get out of the way of it. Stop trying to worry about if somebody is going to think you crazy or not. Just do what he's telling you to do, because God is bigger than the people that call you names. Okay? Trust him. Trust what he's doing in your circumstances. Trust him. Let me tell you guys something. I know too much about him. I know too much about him. Do you understand what I'm saying? I know too much about the Lord. You know, when he tell me to move, I move. And he's saying, this is what he wants his people to do, my little audience, my people, his people. He said, listen to me. Trust that I can move those mountains that's too big for you to move. Trust that I got you in the palm of my hand. Trust that I can make finances come to you where there is no finances in at all, anywhere. But I got you. I just need you to walk it out. I don't need you to be afraid that you don't have enough. I want you to know that you know that you know that I got you. I have you, my child. I have you. Trust that. Trust that I have you. Do not allow another soul on this earth to take you into a place where you feel like that you are not loved. Do not let another soul take you into those dark places, because they're in lower energy, dark lower energy, devil energy. Trust me. I got you. I got you. I got you. I got you. No matter what you're going through, that pain that you having, I need you to just release it and say, this is not my pain. This does not belong to me. God does not give me pain. God gives me peace. He gives me healing. Do you hear what I'm saying? Trust that he's healing you right now. This painting is a healing anointed virtue. Trust that he's got you. Do not trust how bad things are hurting right now. Trust that he's got you, and he can send his he can send his angels right down right now, his creative miracle working angels down right now to heal you if you trust him. Don't worry about the people that's the naysayers, okay? You just keep marching on for the righteousness of the Father. Trust that he's got you. Trust that he's got you. Can you trust him? Will you believe in him? Will you believe that he is over every pain you have? Will you believe that he's over any sickness? No matter what it is, no matter what sickness it is, it could be a terminal sickness. It could be a terminal sickness. But he said, I got you. I'm healing you everywhere you hurt. I'm healing the yeast that you have, that yeast buildup that you have in your body. I'm healing that right now. Trust what I'm saying. I'm healing it. This is the Lord of hosts. And he loves you. He said, I have you. I have that sickness. You have to let the sickness go. Don't keep it. That's not yours to keep. I want you to just release it right now. Just release it from your being and know and forgive it for coming. Thank it for coming and forgive it. Forgive it. I forgive it. Say, I forgive it. Whatever you tried to do. And if there's somebody sending you bad vibes, send it back to them. That's all you got to do. Just send it back. There's people hating on you. Send it back, because you ain't hating on them. So send it back. If they are that dark where they're trying to hurt you in any way, make it be a boomerang effect. Do you understand what I'm saying? And you trust God's got it. Everywhere you hurt, God's got it. That loneliness, that sadness, God's got it. Do you hear what I'm saying? He's got you right there, right there, right where you're at, in the palm of his hand. Do you hear what I'm saying? We trust him. We trust him. Oh, we trust him. Will you trust him? Will you trust him? And know that he's got every pain you're having. Just say, Lord, take it. Let your creative miracles come down right now. Let your creative miracles come down right now, Father. And heal us. Heal us, Father, everywhere we hurt. Heal us, Father. Heal us, Father. Let your healing ointment, your healing anointing come down. Your healing covenant come down right now, Father. We ask for your angelic power to come right now. Right now, Father, and heal us everywhere we hurt. We ask that you are, and we receive that you are shaping us like a diamond. We receive you, Lord. We receive it. And I hope you seal it with a kiss. Father, we love you. We love you. We love you. Oh, we love you, Father. We love you. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. We bless your holy, holy name. And I thank you, Father, for this music, this soaking music. It's not mine, Father, but I thank you that you are using this music to heal your people. Father, we thank you. We thank you, Lord, for everything that you're doing. We bless your name. We bless your name. We bless your name, Lord. How many of you guys out there want to bless his name? No matter what you're going through, bless his name. Do you hear what I'm saying? Bless his name. He said, praise me. Praise me in your sickness. Praise me like you have never praised me before. Praise me and trust. Trust that I got you. Trust that I have you. Can you trust me? Your Father, the creator of the heavens and the earth, can you trust me? Can you trust me? He wants you guys to really start listening to him. Really start listening to the whispers. Because a lot of times you may think those are your whispers, but they're his. And he just wants you guys to open yourselves up and let him be in you. Okay? Just trust him. And we thank him so much. We thank him. Yes, Lord, we thank you. We thank you. Guys, I haven't been on here in a while, but God is telling me right now it's time for me to come back on here and let you guys understand that no matter what you go through, he is always there for you. No matter what the doctors say, he is there. You got to trust him more than doctors. You got to trust him more than your sickness. You got to trust him and know that he will see you through. Do y'all hear what I'm saying? Trust him like you have never trusted him before. And he will make your crooked places straight. Because he's holy. He is a holy God. Do you understand how holy he is? He is the Lord God Almighty. Will you trust him and know that he will guide your way? No matter what things look, how bad things look. He said, I got you. Stop holding on to the pain. Stop holding on to the hurts. that other people gave you, where they want you to look so bad. Will you allow me, your Father in heaven, the Father of the heavens and the earth, to come forth and love on you? Will you allow me to do it? Look at these beautiful colors, guys. He said this is a healing virtue picture. Wherever you're hurting, he said, let it be. Let me take it. I need it. It no longer belongs to you. And I will bring my creative miracles down right now. I will heal kidneys. I will heal your broken heart. I will heal your hurt. I will heal your lungs. I will heal your blood. Will you allow him to heal you? Just say, Lord, I receive your healing anointing powers. I receive your healing oils. Thank you, Father, because you are worthy. Worthy, worthy, worthy to be praised, Father. You are worthy. And I just thank you. I just thank you. I just thank you because you are so holy. You are so holy. Because you are Lord God. He's Lord God, you guys. He's Lord God Almighty. Will you allow him to be the Lord God Almighty in your life? Don't worry about what somebody is saying about you. Don't worry about they're not recognizing you. Just know that God himself, the creator of the heavens and earth, is recognizing you for your good deeds. That's all you need. That's all you need. Will you trust him? Will you trust that he's got you in the palm of his hand? Guys, in the palm of his hand. He loves you. He loves you. He loves you. He loves you. He's sending his healing down upon your naked skin. He's sending that down to you right now. Will you allow him to do it? Will you allow him to be him in you? Or will you get in the way of it? Trust him, trust him, trust him, trust him. He loves you. He loves you. And we just thank him for being holy. He is so holy. Can you praise his name like you've never praised him before? Because he is Lord God, our Lord God Almighty. Will you allow him to come in your circumstances? Let him come in. Let him come in. Let him come in, my little hummingbirds. Come on. Do not be afraid that he's not going to heal you everywhere you hurt. He wants you to give it up. Give up that ghost. Whatever that ghost is, you keep him. Where, oh, this person said this. Don't worry. Don't worry. Let him take your pain. Oh, let him take your pain. He loves you. No matter what it is, no matter what pain you have, joint pain, joint aches, no matter what it is, rheumatoid arthritis, he's got it. Cancer, he's got it. Will you allow him to take it? And you stop trying to hold on to it so tight and keeping it as your own gift. He said, I got you. I got you. I got you. Do you guys see this? This is a rainbow, an angelic rainbow wash over you this night. Okay? Trust that he is healing you everywhere you hurt. Everywhere you hurt. If you just allow him to be him, invoke him and tell him, Father, Let your Holy Spirit fire come and burn this out of me, whatever it is. Lupus, scleroderma, soldiers, whatever it is, cancer, leukemia, AIDS, whatever it is, HIV, whatever it is, Father, we thank you that you are healing those things. And we trust you. We trust your healing, healing virtue. Oh, thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Will you receive his love, guys? Will you receive his love? Just receive it and say, Lord, you know, the devil tried to stop me. He's been trying to stop me, too. He's been trying to make me get too busy to come on here. He's making me have all kinds of pains and stuff. And I said, Lord, you bigger than this pain. And I know you got it. So I'm thanking you like it's already healed. Just trust him though. That's all he wants you to do. That's all he wants you to do. Is trust him. Here come my guy, guys. You might be able to meet him. Okay? Hello? You okay? Yeah, this is right. This is right. I'm doing a painting right now. Hold on, I'm going to show my audience what I did. Okay?
Hold your audience.
My audience. Okay, guys, you might be able to see him right now. Come here, Sonny. This is Mr. Sonny, guys. Can you say hi to the audience? Say hi.
Hi.
Wave at him. And this is my painting, guys. This is the finished product.
Oh.
You like it, Sonny?
Yeah.
Thank you guys for coming into my garden. Because when you come into my garden, you never know. You might meet Mr. Sonny. You never know. Thank you guys, and God bless you. If you like what I did tonight, like, share, comment down below. God bless. Bye.